Okay,
so
all right.
I would say it's
Let's
your
go.
Show if you want.
No.
What? Sounds great for me.
Okay.
Well,
6 o'clock. Everybody's here. We're here to discuss what, if any, but meaning what requirements we want to put on the sale of East Fifth. So, in the past, we've put requirements on lots. You had X amount of time to build. You had to build. I think out there they couldn't put basements in, but
correct. Out there on you're talking about on Cube Avenue.
Yeah. Does this first of all? Let me just ask. Does the city have a recommendation on this?
Well, let's ask Blake. Blake.
As far as what?
Come on over.
So. The requirements for QAV were pretty simple. It was single family home built within 5 years. That was it.
Did we give them 5 years?
When you first did the subdivision.
Yeah.
Oh, but those last couple lots that we sold were super cheap.
Mm-hmm. It was 2 years.
Yeah, it was, I was gonna say, it wasn't that long.
So yeah, those were pretty simple. With these being acquired properties, we should maybe be a little more specific, also because they're in areas that are not brand new development. So the things I have on here are things that maybe we would like to require. Obviously, none of them are things we have to, but these are things a lot of other communities, when they do this sort of thing, they have similar requirements. So the house that was gifted to us, that one is structurally in pretty good shape. I can't speak necessarily to the foundation. I don't have any photos that would show anything to say otherwise, but it's the structure is in decent shape. As you can see, it's completely gutted, so the real hard part's done. It does need a new roof. It leaks. It could be repaired. So, you know, if you want to require a new roof on that, it would be good. If not, repair. Obviously, whoever buys it would want to do that anyway. It does have asbestos siding, so I don't know if that's something that, since we have a chance to control the covering up of that or whatever, it's not in the best shape. It's not in the worst shape. So those are two things that we have a chance to control. If it's not something anybody feels is very important, obviously we don't have to require those. Obviously it's gutted, so putting everything up to code isn't a big deal because you gotta put all new in anyway.
Well, I think what we've done before, like with this house right over here, LG&G or whatever the other part is. We told them that they had to have the outside done within 6 months. You remember that thing?
I don't.
Well, they bought that and they had to have the outside done within, I think it was like 6 or 9 months.
Yes.
Thank you.
I don't remember the time frame, but I know that because it was a flood house, the outside had to be cleaned up and presentable, and then they could take their time on the inside.
And then they could take the time on the inside.
Yep. The natural way would be is do the outside until winter hit, and go inside, finish the inside is what most people would do. Or do the whole thing.
I don't think we should go any longer than 6 months.
No. I'm just giving an example of what we've done. I think we did it someplace else, too.
They're going to have a ton of money wrapped up in the inside of it. My feeling is that they can pretty up the outside. The siding is all there. Yeah, it's not perfect, but you can still make a, you know, is this going to be a $175,000 house when it's done, or is it going to be $110,000 for a little family to get into? you actually go to the extreme of new roof, new siding, complete inside, replacing the garage, all the things on the list, it's gonna be a high dollar property.
Well, the roof's a definite.
Huh?
The roof is a definite, you have to do that.
Well.
If it's leaking.
Yeah, but, I mean, just, I looked at it, and it's obviously fixable, it's all, I mean, it's like, it's three layers with, I mean, it's, yeah, I mean, obviously, some, whoever advises it is gonna make so it doesn't leak. And you're not gonna, aren't they? I mean.
What conversations we had yesterday.
But, like, come on.
You would hope they would put on a roof, is what you're saying, at a minimum?
But that's not a good.
Yeah, what?
Or smear blackjack on it. Also, would stop it from leaking for time. So I guess it's gonna, I think what would guide the rest of this would be what sort of requirement do we want for occupancy?
Yeah.
Because obviously if it's gonna be owner occupied, our requirements don't necessarily need to be as cut and dried because they're gonna live there. Of course they don't want their roof to leak for a very long time, so they might be willing to deal with the requirement of putting a new roof on.
And as for the slate siding?
Again, you know, lots of houses in town have it. This is just our chance to maybe make one less in town with it. So it's not in terrible shape. You know, it's there's some of it's cracked, but it's not like large portions of it are missing.
Well, I guess what I'm looking at is the inside gutting part is a lot of it. So in order to conform to whatever we decide about the outside, some of their work has been done already, so they would have a little extra money to do a roof, change the siding, or because really you can paint it, but if it's cracked in numerous places and it looks like there's some of the corners that are gone on it,
and the siding on that porch is cedar shakes, that's not in great shape.
Yeah, it's tough, but of course it's tough.
But like I said, a lot of the demo's been done inside, so they can, if no matter what they want to do, they could put the money into the outside first and then do the inside at a later date or whatever. But they still, as you say, that's my thing.
Okay, so let's go down the list one at a time and talk about opening bid. Do we want to set a minimum?
So I tallied up attorney fees and any leftover abatement stuff. The house for my activities is sitting with right around $2,000, roughly $1,700 in attorney fees, and a single $53 mowing bill, because the rest of the abatement stuff was put as a personal judgment, and a $125 to insert, so right around $2,000 is what I've got wrapped up in it.
Opening bid of $5,000.
No, that was just what I was thinking. It was fine. I wasn't bidding on it.
Oh.
No!
What's that?
Yeah, bye.
Which an opening bid of $5,000 would leave a lot of room for upgrades. Because realistically, you're going to have good plumbing and electrical and heating. You're going to have
at least
wrapped up in it.
At least.
My best guess is $85,000 to get the house done. That's just educated.
Including roof.
Okay,
roof.
So opening bid of $5,000.
You're looking at $90 invested in it. You got to get the profits.
Okay. Closed or open? In what situation would it open and be better?
Higher price.
Yeah, higher price, because they can see.
Everybody be sitting here.
It'll go up.
Damn, be the auctioneer.
Because was the Q Ave, were those closed bids?
Yes.
The one we looked at, it sold for $13 above opening bid.
Yeah.
Ron, the other one is the one that you and Michael John bid on against Boots, her across from John's.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And that was an open here.
Yep.
So open, okay? Item three, single family, owner occupied or rental?
I think if we're requiring a certain level of upgrades, I think it's really up to them.
I do too, I think single family, but.
Yeah.
I don't think it's big enough for.
It's not.
No, but you can still rent it out to somebody.
Yeah. But they gotta bring that code.
Right, which is down further. So single family then?
Yep.
Time to complete, exterior 6 months, 4 months? It'll be during the spring and summer, so. I mean, whoever buys it isn't gonna waste any time anyway, but just so we can.
It kind of depends on what we're going to require. We might come back to that. If we're gonna require new roof, new on the list. I mean, if we don't require some of that, it's not gonna take as much time, but yeah. And none, absolutely before winter. I mean, that's no brainer.
Yeah.
It's just, that's an easy one.
So we'll start with 6 months minimum to
go
back.
Yeah.
Okay, on down to project requirements. Can you side over the asbestos siding or does
no?
Mm-mm.
Because you try to drill, I mean, you'd have to drill everything, and it breaks.
Your fasteners go bad.
Plus it's asbestos.
Very practical.
Plus it's asbestos, and then you start where, I mean, if the homeowner's doing it, he can do it legally himself.
Yeah.
So minimum repaint is a definite requirement.
I agree with that.
At a minimum. I'm just thinking, if we put a re-siding on there, we're going to lose a bunch of bidders right then and there.
Compared to paint,
because
it's more expensive.
Painting, yeah. We'd get them a couple years before. Just my thought. What do you guys think about the roof?
I think it needs a new roof. Or something done with that roof. The side's just black. Yeah, I mean, I don't know how you word that. I agree, obviously, you don't want something up just slapping some blackjack up there.
Are the shingles curling, or?
Another way, there's something going underneath going.
Well, so if you've got that situation going on, the wood in there has got the sheeting or whatever there has gotten wet for how long?
Mm-hmm.
Since it's been empty, which has been a while. So you've got rot, possibly. So I would say it needs a new roof.
Is that part of your inspection that you can check that to see how the roof shape is?
Oh yeah, I can go in there.
I would think he can make that determination seems that it's messed up.
I mean, my initial opinion as we sit now is it should have a new roof, but I could go and officially say it needs a new roof as well.
I like that.
Okay.
With your confirmation, that sound all right?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yep.
Make sure it's part of the requirement unless you come up saying, nope, that's in great shape.
Okay.
Well, he's already told us there's a few holes in it. Replacement of garage, I don't know about replacement, but demolition.
Yeah, the garage is in, it's in pretty rough shape. It's not really a usable, you couldn't, you'd have a hard time pairing that garage with somebody who has a car that would fit in it.
So it had to be a removal or replacement of garage.
Yeah, I mean, it's, it would take a, it would take somebody a lot of effort to straighten it up, make it a decent garage, and then still probably not be able to fit a vehicle in it. So I guess.
So removal.
Remove, yeah, remove or replace, one or the other.
Okay. They want to replace it, they can,
but. And there's, there is room, if they take it down, there is room to put a decent garage back up.
Okay.
Okay.
Bring the interior up to code, yes. That's given.
So, if they turn it into a rental, the new code has to be sprinkled now, or is that all?
It would, it would still be new construction, so it'd have to be brought up to current codes. And, and that, the structure as it sits is, like, as far as space and egress, it's compliant, so that wouldn't be an issue. And it, you'd only get into an issue with our rental code and that stuff if you started trying to chop it up.
What say you on the flooring?
So the reason the city first really got involved with this property was because it was vacant and a pipe burst in the winter. And when officers and water department entered the house, there was ice covering the floors, ice chandeliers. So portions of it, the floor has pretty bad water damage and definitely would need to be replaced. The rest of it is just in rough condition. It did, while it was vacant and unsecured, have a lot of cats in it. So really, anyone who takes it on is probably going to want to refinish or replace this, or put new flooring down anyway. So I would definitely require that.
Cats, you said?
Cats.
Many
so at a minimum, you should do a subfloor inspection before they recover to make sure they're not just covering up holes.
Yeah. So I don't know if that would have to be on this, but that's just up to obviously the inspection when the construction is going on, whatever is required.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I think at the end of this, we'll button it up with all per inspection.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and obviously we've got a little time before we need to officially put anything together, so I can do like an official inspection of the property, because I haven't really been in it since they walked away and it went into foreclosure, because it kind of went off my plate at that point. So, but yeah, the roof, the subfloor, the foundation, that sort of thing.
I'm not a fan of requiring paved parking.
No,
that's expensive.
Either.
One of six.
It's not something we require everywhere else, is it?
No.
Just that we have some sort of surfaced space, gravel, asphalt, paved.
At least off-street parking.
Off-street. We do.
Well, if there's a garage down, is there a cement floor in the garage?
There's concrete. It's pretty broken.
Yeah. Right there.
Okay.
So you want to provide improved off-street parking? Does not have any right now.
It has a kind of gravel area between the house and the garage. It looks like at one point there was railroad ties kind of creating a more level area where there was more parking, maybe. But, it, I mean, if it's going to be a rental, we require two off-street parking for single units. And it's going to have official, I would say, parking per city ordinances, which has a definitive square footage.
With that here or not, because if it's per city ordinance, they're going to have it.
Yeah. So. I just don't want to require it to be
paved. I think it'll be required just because.
What will be required?
Off not the paid.
Yeah.
Just
the
parking. Just parking. Yeah. And the sidewalk.
How bad
I said it'll have to be required if the city has to do with it. It would be specially assessed. I
I just threw that in there as, since we're taking a pretty sad property and hopefully giving it a really nice facelift, a brand new sidewalk would be nice too, and that might be a deal or no deal for a lot of people if they are required to do it, and if we could do it and assess it to the property and it's something that's paid off over time, that'd be nice.
What's the sidewalk look next to it?
Next to it? All the same.
So not good.
Not awesome.
So put a new sidewalk in front of here and then not.
Maybe it'll start a trend.
No.
I don't
not
think
there.
So.
I really don't think so.
I would say we have to require a new sidewalk, whether the city puts it in or the new owner does.
Okay.
It must be in bad shape.
It's in as good a shape as a lot of the sidewalks in town. It should be replaced. It's cracked. It's not as wide as it should be.
You can inspect that as well.
That'll be part of it too.
Oh, yeah.
It's not a huge amount of square footage there, but
it's one of the shortest sections of sidewalk you got in town.
And if they were to do it, they would, I assume, qualify for the sidewalk fund.
Mm-hmm. You sure
yes.
would think.
So.
Mm-hmm. The $750, yes.
Which would go a long way on that. Okay, do we want to recap now, Chris, on this one, and then we'll move on to the next one?
Sure, it makes sense to me to recap it. So it's going to be opening bid is going to be 5.
Yep.
Looking at closed bid?
Open bid.
Open bid, that's right, open bid.
No closed bidding?
No.
Really is the choice of single family owner or occupy rental, either one is.
It's got to stay single family, though.
Yeah, it's going to stay single family.
Yep.
It's topping it out. Time to complete, look at what, 6 months?
Time to complete
exterior.
6 months minimum. Mm-hmm.
Do we want a cap on the
that minimum
total
or maximum?
Project?
Oh, maximum.
Yeah.
Maximum, sorry, yep. Do we want to cap what?
Is that from date of close, I would assume?
Total completion. Final inspection, here's your deed.
Certificate of occupancy.
On
yeah,
the outside or the
to
inside?
Well, the whole
we're
project.
We're talking outside of 6 months, and then when is the complete job?
Yeah.
Is it a year?
When you brought everything up to code, then you'll get the deed.
1 year.
When that passes this thing.
One year.
Within 12 months, I should say.
Yeah.
12 months total or 12
months
after
total.
6 months?
Total.
Yep, bring everything up to code. In other words, in the 12-month time, that is a certificate of occupancy, in other words, correct?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And so from date of close or from date of
I guess
bid.
That could, I mean, whatever we decide, whatever language the attorney puts together for that sales agreement, I guess.
It should be date of close, because nobody's going to want to take money into it until they own it.
A lot of communities, though, do withhold deed until the project is done. That way, if somebody gets in and doesn't finish, the city can take it back over.
I would assume that's what Doug would recommend, so we'll go with his recommendation on that.
I just want to make sure that's clearly stated.
Yeah. And then down to the roof, that will require new with Blake's input.
Mm-hmm. Re-side, repaint, yes, either one. It'll be up to them. To
minimum
decide.
Of one, mm-hmm. though. Minimum of repainting.
Is the porch in that bad a shape?
I didn't go inside the property. I looked at the outside. It again, can't read the mind of the owner, but
is it dumpy looking porch
that you would think they would redo.
Leaning away from the house? Is it separating from the house?
I didn't look at it. It's just a really dumpy looking
porch. No, you don't drive past it and think, oh, that porch is falling off. It just, the shakes are in really bad shape. A lot of them are missing.
Yeah.
There's some openings underneath of it that cats are living in, so, I mean.
Anybody that's putting this much money into the place
is going to do something about it.
Yeah.
But inside on the porch, it's in decent shape. It's a linoleum floor. It's got newer windows.
Yeah, I didn't think the floor was that bad.
Okay.
I just know some of them around town and they are.
Yeah. Yes.
Sinking in the front.
And down to the garage, requirement of removal or replacement.
Mm-hmm. Yep, removal or replacement.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
All of the code, yes, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
Flooring.
Yeah, well, cats. Paved parking, not necessarily paved, but some kind of surface.
Yeah.
One last question.
But we're not putting flooring in the bid, are we? Because that was something that is going to be up to you and during the construction.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, and I will try to get. I will get over there. I assume it'll be very easy for Wells Fargo to give us access. I'll get over there and I can look at the subflooring, the roof, the foundation, the porch, and we can fine tune that.
Pressure
cam.
I doubt if Craig's put a heater pit in there yet.
Well, then they'll be ready.
Probably should have him do that while we still own it.
Is that, well, that's the other thing you need to check. Is that galvanized or is it?
Is it copper? Or?
Well, there's some PEX in it.
Right, I'm talking main coming in
to
the house. Yeah. If it's galvanized, which I'm going to bet it probably is.
Unless it got replaced or something broke, and then it could have gotten replaced a long time. Doubtful, but it could.
I don't remember it happening, but it's possible.
Okay.
We probably wouldn't require them to put a new water line in just because it's galvanized.
Nope. I don't
think
so.
Yeah, I mean,
well, there again, if we're not going to put a new water line in, as long as it's not leaking, then we're not going to put a meter bit in.
Fair enough.
I wasn't planning on putting a meter bit in.
Right, but I'm just clarifying that again for the 10th time.
But,
we're not touching galvanized lines if they're not leaking.
Oh,
if it's lead, all bets are off.
But it won't be lead coming in the house.
No.
It'll be lead coming off the main.
Right.
But you're not going to know that until you dig down the main.
Bingo. Chicken and egg, bro.
So we're good with that?
Yes. This is the debate since the beginning.
Sure, we'll revisit this 20 more times before we.
Alright.
Okay.
6:30 on the nose.
Cruising on down to West 6th Street.
So this one the city's been dealing with for a long time. There was a house there, caught on fire. City special assessed the cost to clean that up. It was sold at tax sale. Those people immediately stopped paying their taxes also. It had tens of thousands of dollars of back taxes and the former special assessment against it. So the county ended up with it, and then they just sat on it for years while we mowed it. So we got the certificate signed over to us, and I went through the process of getting a tax title and deed for that. There was some mowing and we tore down the shed back there. We moved a camper from the site, so attorney fees was around $350, a $150 lien search, and like $2,000 and change for abatement that I did that you can't special assess to somebody who's not paying their taxes and nobody's selling that tax certificate. So we were looking at roughly $3,000 of costs incurred since I got involved with it. It's a huge lot. It's a little narrow, obviously, but really, really, really deep.
Is there any structure on that at all anymore? Is that building that
was
back?
Yeah, it's not there. There's just a slab in the back.
There used to be a garage.
Shed.
No restrictions on putting up size of house on there, as long as it fits the setbacks?
Yeah, as long as it fits setbacks. And so the lot to the east of it was recently acquired by a gentleman through the tax certificate process. So he owns that, and he's actually been trying to sell it as well. So you're looking at possibly two lots that somebody could combine into one there. So I think there's quite a bit of interest in the sale of this lot. A lot of people have
inquired
about it and the lot next to it. The owner of the lot next to it has been talking about people asking him if he owns the other one. So this one will be interesting. Because if you got two, you got enough room with a pretty large multifamily. Right, but if you own both, you only have to sign for yourself.
Which we did that across the street, across the block,
yes,
a few years back. So
that was right when I started, I remember that. The water, because it was a house there before, the water is still there, obviously.
Yeah, for both lots.
For both lots.
There was a house in recent history.
You're trying to think of where
lot.
It's at.
No, I know where it's at. I was trying to remember if it's got, if the water line is copper or galvanized again in either one of them, because I used to do work in both of them. Mm-hmm. And I think they're both galvanized, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I don't
know. I just said let's start at $5,000.
But that's brick street out in front of that.
Yes, it is.
So then you'd have to get into the brick street, put a new water line in. If somebody would buy both lots, they'd almost have to put a new water line in to build a nice house.
So Bud wants opening bid at 5.
Interest. Should go right above really quick.
So open bidding again on that one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You're going to be auctioning them all.
How long are we leaving these bids open for?
No less than 4, but no more than 20. You do 420 rule on that.
No less than 4 what?
4
days.
Mm-hmm.
No more than 20 days.
Yeah, and then you have your public hearing and then have a hearing. You have people here doing whatever.
Yeah, they come in here and do the bidding, right?
Yeah.
You can, or you can take them sealed as envelope, but at
that's
the time
closed
that's
bidding.
closed,
but you can take somebody.
Yeah, because I think we had an open bidding one night where nobody bid.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I still think that's the way to go.
Yeah, I remember the one up there on 8th and 2nd, or 2nd and 8th.
So if we do it that way, we just set the date and have them come here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's do it that way.
Yeah, you have your date of your public hearing, and then you just do it that way, and then people will come.
Okay.
Do it right after the public hearing, or do we have to wait?
To accept?
But the public hearing is going to be the bidding?
Yes.
Well, you have your bidding, and then you have your public hearing.
Yeah.
To accept it?
To accept it.
Okay, so as long as we get the right order of things here.
Yeah, it's been a couple of times.
Yeah.
A while. But we've done it before.
Anyhow, we'll do it here.
Yes. Okay, I like that.
And plus, Plus, by doing it in a public hearing, you also get, we accept bids over Zoom.
If they do it over Zoom, they're gonna have to identify who they are, though.
That's true.
And we want to, and we want to do both on the same evening, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, my vote. All right, so. So here we, time to complete.
That's tough.
You wanna give them 2 years? Maximum.
I think that's what we did on Q.
Yeah, the last five.
On the last 2 lots.
Oh.
Yeah, I think it was.
It was 2 years for those.
Okay.
You're not gonna restrict it, cause maybe he does buy the other lot.
Yeah. And, you know, if they run, if whomever might be interested runs into some time issues in getting the second lot acquired, we're pretty easy to work with if they need it.
Yeah.
As long as they're maintained.
There's nothing left there to fall down.
Correct.
Cause if they buy it, they are going to maintain it, right?
Yep. Single family, correct?
Zone multifamily.
Is it? So they can do a duplex?
Yep.
There's
Square foot.
47 buildable width there. So, I mean, you could do it. It would be more of a long duplex.
Yeah, you'd be better off to get the other lot and then you can do whatever you wanted, basically.
Okay, so we're not gonna restrict that.
No.
Okay, cool. I like that better.
And everything else is just gonna be to code.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We can't require covered parking.
No, no.
It's nice to have, but
you don't, can't require it.
Is there sidewalk there?
You can.
You can't, is there?
If we're selling it, we can, but it, I mean, it's not. I see it as their requirement all the time.
Yeah, the question is, I don't think this neighborhood.
It's not worth it.
Yeah, this neighborhood doesn't have, have covenants on it.
I see a lot of vehicles parked outside.
Mm-hmm.
In the picture.
At the neighborhood.
But, so the minimum square footage though, if someone does buy it, do we wanna see a minimum size? Maybe someone could put a 660 square foot house there to rent if they wanted, or if they do wanna see minimum 1200?
I'd say minimum 12.
What's the adjoining houses? Any idea?
The one next door, that's probably 15, it's two story, pushing 16, that's a pretty big house. Houses across the street are decent size.
Yeah, those are all big houses over there.
I'd be okay with the minimum 1250.
1250.
What's everybody else?
Did you set her on?
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you said, 1250?
I said
1,000 to 1,200. Cause you've got, you said 47.
Buildable width.
Feet buildable width. I mean, you can make it as long as you want.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. 47's actually pretty wide.
Yeah, I mean,
that's pretty good size.
Is,
so,
my,
I mean,
house,
you can fit
30 wide, maybe.
Yeah, mine's like 32. You can fit
a big house there.
Yeah.
I'd just leave it minimum 1,200.
Yeah.
That way, it just kind of fits the neighborhood.
Yep.
The cupcake song. That's my
name.
It was hers.
I know.
I didn't hear it. What was yours?
The cupcake song.
The cupcake song.
The what?
Mine is not that song.
Each
one on my phone.
Oh boy. Oh, I thought maybe that was Bob.
Yeah.
And same thing with the sidewalk. It's gonna get a new sidewalk.
The minimum number of units. If someone, whoever buys it, does want to use it as a rental property, do you want to see it be at least a duplex, or just leave that to whatever they want to do?
If it's gonna be multi-family, would it at least have to be a duplex?
Well, it doesn't have to be.
He's saying if it's a rental property, do we want it to have a duplex? I don't want to go that restrictive.
We'll figure it out. You'll have to come in and get approved anyhow.
Yeah, but do you want a fourplex or an eightplex there?
Well, you'd have a hard time doing that if you don't get the other lot.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying, you want, I mean, I realize right down on the corner, there's, what is that?
4 or 5.
That's what I thought.
Well, that corner next to it, then down the block, it's 6.
You can make a fourplex as long as you don't abandon the alley.
Yeah, it's a 12-foot wide alley. A lot of potential there.
I don't really want to get into requirements of that, as long as they do everything they do to code.
There you go.
You?
Okay. And then the same with sidewalks, you said?
Yeah. Okay. You said, you gotta take advantage of that.
All right, you want to recap us on that one, Chris?
5,000 opening bid, open bidding. You got 2 years, 24 months to complete. No restrictions, and everything's got to be built up to code. We're looking at a 1,200 square foot house minimum with sidewalks.
Yep.
That lot.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And then. Do we have to wait till our next council meeting to set the public hearing? Can we do that tonight?
I believe it's not on your agenda.
Yeah. Okay.
In the past, I dug up some of the old resolutions from the other properties the city has sold, and we put together a resolution, you know, spelling out the address and legal description, all that jazz, that we're going to sell by auction with the public hearing date and the auction date.
Okay, so you need time.
And put that in a resolution form.
Okay.
So
you'll have that at the next meeting.
Okay. And Blake, we close on both of these properties.
We close on the vacant lot on the 14th, and close with Wells Fargo for the house on the 17th of April.
So okay. How about the first week of May, if you have all that ready? Make sure we're closed on them.
Yeah, that's all.
Like the first council meeting in May.
Yeah.
You're thinking for
get them auctioned off and be done.
Yep. So the last council meeting in April, is that the public hearing?
As long as we know we're closed on everything.
That should work. Okay.
So we have to have a public hearing first.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And then the auction, can those happen the same night?
They can happen the same night.
They have historical looking
over. Well, if we're closed, maybe shoot for the last one in April. If we're closed on them.
Does that give you, that doesn't give her enough time to
advertise. Advertise. Publication.
And, I mean, that doesn't get that it's a whole lot of time here.
No.
All right, back to the first meeting in May.
Gotcha.
Should have stuck in my head.
Ted, did they get our guy, or do we need to have a search party?
If you want to go look, settle down, Tammy.
Oh, I'll go with you.
That's right. We can pan out.
I think they're good.
We
got 15 minutes.
Oh, is he?
I think he's taken care of.
The streaker waits.
There's a naked
what?
Man running.
There's
around
a street.
It just so happened to be when you were here. We were kind of wondering.
Blind eye, Chief.
There's
a
guy who knows how to do it, too.
Leave me out of it.
Hell, you'd be right beside me, man. You don't have to deny it. You know it's true.
I don't know what you're talking about. But.
Yeah.
And
probably better, Kevin.
He showed up about the same time.
Yeah.
All right, what are we pulling off this, Melissa?
Nothing.
The last I heard, we're pulling off the dedication.
Why?
Because I heard it wasn't ready yet. We're waiting for some confirmation.
It's not what I heard.
I think it's...
Unless you got it all day.
Yeah, I think it's going, but...
When I left at 4 o'clock, it's going.
We got it, and this is so everything you listed in here is fine?
Yeah, there's info at your seats.
Ready to go.
Oh, yeah. Your pinky.
Are we...
So the streaking accident?
No.
Streaking accident?
So far, yeah. It's good. It's still good.
I would have
done that. He was just waiting for one last little thing on that warranty.
You have,
hey, you'd be wrong by me, Blake, and I'll give you the old.
Price, yeah.
That's what I mean. So that's why we're taking this because of that.
He said you have a choice. What did you think? You can either accept as is or you can accept the medication.
If you ever wanted to bring me, I would never turn it down.
Last
but
warranty
have to
for the attorney. And if you need to call Doug, I got his number.
I know, I'm just waiting for the answer. I saw the email file last night.
What I got.
That's why I thought this was going to get out of love. And I thought we weren't going to do it with all the utilities with us.
Well, are you doing this for us? It's just the electrical for REC.
You can have mine.
REC, according to Doug.
Well, I know where you're, what you have in your drawer.
Hey, I said don't touch what's in the drawer. You can have what's in the bowl.
So REC,
totally
done.
Hey, I need you to sign your nieces up for visioning.
This is all part of the warranty.
Yeah, how's that going?
All that stuff's all covered in the schedule.
Thanks for all the help.
I had kids. Not mine.
I have kids too.
They didn't want to come.
Are mine.
I offered.
So that excuse doesn't hold much water.